Tom Nears is here to talk about geospatial metadata for discovery and scholarly publishing. Tom is a student at the Institute of Geoinformatics, the University of Münster, Germany. He's currently writing his bachelor thesis, and furthermore, he works as a student assistant in the project Opening Reproducible Research. So over to you, Tom.
Yes, I hope you can see my screen. Hello, everyone. Thanks for the short introduction. Great to be here. Today I will talk about geospatial metadata for discovery and scholarly publishing and O2R, so Opening Reproducible Research, has supported me, and especially Daniel Nüst was involved in research on this topic. Let's start. Almost every scientific article that refers to existing regions of the Earth contains a narrative description of the study area. But nevertheless, more than a quarter of articles omit maps and coordinates and only use vague descriptions, albeit the relevance of location for said article's content. This contradicts the potential that the use of geospatial metadata has. First, geospatial metadata can help to detect biases in research coverage. It can be determined which areas of investigation occur disproportionately often and which are neglected. This knowledge can be used as an additional factor in the selection of future study areas to avoid redundancy. Second, correlations can become visible, which otherwise would not be noticed. If one recognizes similar behavior in different studies based on the location, one can possibly transfer results or even just use methods. Third, research results for scientific articles can be filtered by integrating geospatial filters. Most of today's search engines for scientific articles are thematically based and leave out geographical data for filtering. The integration of geographical data into the search filter would increase the hits for potential interesting articles. Fourth, geospatial metadata can enhance the understanding of relations within a study area. Thus, both the regional and global context of case study becomes knowable. The availability of comprehensive geospatial metadata can facilitate reuse and citation of published work. Fifth, geospatial metadata enables creation of maps. Interactive maps provide authors with another way of presenting the article's spatial properties. The user is able to gain deeper insight and achieve a broader overview over the data. The multitude of possibilities that geospatial metadata offers lead to demand on journals and publishers to provide geospatial metadata in a default manner. At first sight, this potential mentioned certainly appeals to scientists in whose research locations are of high relevance, so primarily scientific works from the natural science context. But at least any scientific work that refers to a location can benefit, whether it is specifically about a single location, different places and their comparison, or a historical comparison. To make geospatial metadata usable for the discovery of scientific articles, different aspects have to be considered. First of all, the data must be collected. There are two main opportunities to collect geospatial data of scientific articles. On the one hand, the scientific article, for example, the text, contain figures and data sets can be used as databases. An examination of the scientific article can capture information about location and time of the article's content. On the other hand, the data can become available by other means without analyzing the article. The author can add the geospatial metadata himself by an input or also in form of a further file upload. Second, there is a need to standardize the data in order to achieve comparability between different articles. Otherwise, the variety of occurrences types and the associated errors can lead to the fact that the potential of storing geospatial metadata cannot be fully exploited. Third, the data has to be stored adequately to make them in many different ways usable and accessible for a broader user group. It is important to ensure that an appropriate database is available that is capable of storing geospatial data and that the data are stored in such a way that the potential of the data can be exploited. Fourth, validation is worth considering to verify the validity of the data. Validity checks as part of the peer review in the review process should be considered. Although peer review can be extended by this, a check by another person besides the author is quite reasonable. As there are automated approaches to collect the geospatial metadata, they can also be used for validation. To give an insight how to exploit the potential of geospatial metadata, we developed GeoOGS. GeoOGS offers a novel way for authors to provide spatial properties of research works when submitting an article to a journal based on the open source software Open Journal Systems. For those who are not familiar with OGS, OGS is an open source software tool for scholarly publishing developed by PKP. The entire workflow for scholarly publishing is covered flexible and extensible. For this purpose, plugins can extend the system and add new features. We implemented a plugin named GeoOGS as prototype for OGS. Previous work applied text recognition or pattern matching algorithm to derive geospatial metadata from papers, but such fully automated workflows are not without shortcomings. Instead, we decided to streamline the user interaction to create geospatial metadata so that users' understanding of the most suitable connections with locations or areas is unambiguously recorded. Authors can either search for a location and accept the suggested bounding box, or manually create one or more suitable geometric shapes on a map. If authors enter geometries, a gazetteer is used to suggest matching administrative unit's name to the author. This allows GeoOGS to store geospatial data in two forms, as text using the administrative unit and as geospatial coordinates in GeoJSON format. Thereby, the coordinates are stored accurately, while at the same time a textual description is accessible and flexible for non-app-related use. In addition to displaying geospatial information on maps, it is also added to the HTML source code of articles' landing pages in a semantically meaningful way. This facilitates indexing by search engines and can improve accessibility by supporting screen readers better than a regular map. Here you can see a screenshot of the OGS submission view extended by the GeoGS plugin. The geospatial metadata can be defined by the author below the usual metadata, like the title or the abstract. First, the temporal properties can be set either by keyboard input or by selection in the calendar widget. Second, the spatial properties can be defined. Authors can either search for location and accept the suggested bounding box, or manually create one or more suitable geometric shapes on a map. There's a choice of markers, rectangles, polygons, or polylines. All inputs can be edited or deleted again. If authors enter geometric shapes either manually or by search, a gazetteer is used to suggest a matching administrative unit's name to the author. Each time the geometric shapes on map change, the administrative units that fit for all geometric shapes displayed on the map are newly calculated and proposed. Just as well, the author can define an administrative unit by textual input themselves. I recorded a video so that you can take a closer look which features the plugin offers. First, I search as an author for my research area. Surprisingly, it's Tromsø. I hope I pronounce it correctly. A blue bounding box is displayed for my search and the administrative unit is displayed in black. In addition, all higher level administrative units are displayed as text. It is possible to delete the administrative units and add them again. Accordingly, the lowest level administrative unit in the map adapts. Right now, the bounding box is too imprecise for me, so I delete it. With it, also the administrative units disappear. I use the zoom function to have a closer look at Tromsø. Now I can narrow down my research area, the Lake Prespanet, more precise by forming a polygon. Oh, I realized that my scientific article covers even more areas, so I quickly set a marker. And another polygon. Oh, that was a little too fast, but luckily I can adjust it again. According to the input, the administrative units adapt themselves again and again. Besides the submission view, there's also an article view. Here, the reader can view the article. Besides the usual information, like title and abstracts, GeoGS plugin provides the additional display of geospatial metadata. The temporal properties are displayed textually and the spatial properties are shown on a map. In addition, the administrative units are listed. Furthermore, the geospatial metadata are published in the HTML source code. For this purpose, various standards are used to store the administrative units in text form as coordinates and also the temporal properties. Future work includes research into usability and usefulness of geospatial metadata for discovery of articles, a search engine across OGS instances, geospatial and temporal filters in article search, and validation of geospatial metadata as part of the review process. We plan to release GeoGS in the OGS plugin gallery so that the increasing number of independent and open access journals may benefit from it. At the moment, GeoGS is available on GitHub or as a release on Zenodo. Thanks for your attention and keep your question in mind for the Q&A.
And then there's a question for Tom. The GeoGS, is the plugin available and open source? And if so, is there a URL to the download to download the plugin?
Yeah, the plugin is of course open source available. We want to publish it in the OGS plugin gallery, and so at the moment it is available on GitHub and Zenodo. I think the slides will be published with the corresponding links to GitHub and Zenodo after the conference. But of course, I can also put the links in the chat here if it is okay.
That's great, thank you. There is another question which I can ask it. I can see your colleague has, for Tom, I see your colleague have already asked for a clarification, but let's see. The GeoGS, can one make exact location only available after approval? Might be needed for protecting where new species are found or location is made imprecise. Are you able to answer that question?
Yeah, I think so. So it's a good question. For areas which should not be shown exactly for reasons of species protections or also cultural reasons, one can skip the place, and it is of course not required. So I think there isn't a approval function at the moment, but GeoGS offers a nice way to solve this. So you can just skip the exact location and only save and display the fitting administrative unit. So there is at least a rough spatial classification, but without revealing details and the exact location.
Thank you. There's a comment here that this is to prevent misuse, and conservation biologists need that, which we all agree with, of course.